And there's something that's not going to happen tonight, and that is the barbecue. But we're going to talk about it anyway, because tis the season.
We're going to talk about your barbecuing?
We're going to talk about barbecuing, not my barbecuing. So this is an interesting story. We got brats, we got burgers, we got steak. You name it, I'll eat it. And these are all things, of course, that we cook on the grill.
Yeah, comes up every year. Before your Memorial Day weekend, we want to get this debate out of the way so you can win in the lawn chairs with your friends. Can grilling food cause cancer? Maybe over-grilling food. Adrian Broaddus is going to get to the bottom of this in a Verify.
I'll sit for a minute.
Families are firing up their grills.
What's easy?
As we head into the summer months.
Especially with a gas grill, what could be easier?
But is easy the best option? Some love that charred meat, but is it safe? We asked Monica Will. She directs nutrition and food services at Methodist Hospital in St. Louis Park.
There is always questions that come up with, could it cause cancer if I eat too much of this?
It, meaning burnt meat, does it cause cancer?
There is some evidence that if you cook at a high temperature, it could do that, if that's all you ever ate over the course of a year, or if you cook everything to a burnt state.
What is considered a high temperature?
A flame that's coming off your grill that's really burning a product. If you're cooking your meat too high and it gets a piece of hard burnt on it, you should cut that piece off and discard that.
You say cut the burnt part off.
Yes.
Some of the men in my family will say that's the best part of the meat.
Yeah, see, a lot of people like that taste of that charcoal burnt. And actually, it's not the best thing for us to eat. When you eat meat like that, it can change your DNA composition. Now, if I get into all the chemistry, nobody's going to really want to know that.
Oh, you might be surprised. Not trying to grill you, but we want more.
Well, you're changing the composition of your meat. And the meat is a piece of muscle, and this is really technical. There's proteins in it, which are amino acids, and you can change the composition of that.
So, are warnings that say grilling meat, poultry, and fish can create carcinogens wrong?
And it may cause cancer. I mean, they don't know. There's nothing that we can definitely say it's going to do that. I mean, you can get a piece of smoked salmon or smoked meats that can cause the same effect as grilling a piece of meat on a grill.
So what do we do? Boil everything?
No. Yuck. I grill my food, but do I do it every night? Probably not. I would advise them to do it in moderation. It's summertime. People are going to grill their food.
Good old moderation.
This story bugged me this morning. It still bugs me right now. Probably because I take it so personally. I like burnt stuff. I like burnt bacon. I like char on a steak. I like all that stuff.
No one said you can't like it. She's just, there's health risks,
it just bugs me. It just bugs me. What am I supposed to do? So you eat it raw, you're going to get E. coli. If you eat meat, you get cancer. If you burn meat, you get cancer. You're supposed to just be a vegan.
Wouldn't be the worst idea. It works for Rebecca Brunson.
Just be like, stop being so bitter, Chris.
Yeah, really. Seriously. What's wrong with you?
Okay.